山。山。One day, when you're on the battlefield, you're going to feel something. Something in your stomach. That's fear, my son. Fear. Never fear, my son. Never be afraid.
people of Rome. People of Rome. Romans, citizens. Once again, we've managed to bring back security to our Roman provinces. Many, many thought that Attila could never be defeated. In fact, some even thought that this victory could never happen, that Rome could never ever happen out of victory. But in Gaul, we've proven that wrong. When at the Battle of Chalons, when we defeated the Huns ran from us. Once again, Rome has proven that even Attila, the so-called wrath of God, cannot stand up to the Roman legions. Our Roman legions, Rome!
Thank you. politician general.
Yes. The mongoose has killed the snake. Now, what do we do about the mongoose?
Nothing. Now, we wait.
All hail, Black Xavius, conqueror of the Hun!
So, my new friend, my young Livius, how does it feel?
My lord, I don't understand.
Oh, you know, such fame at such young age.
Well, my lord, I can say I'm honored. I can guarantee that I can protect.
You can dispense with the amenities. I'm still a soldier, I'm not a politician. You understand?
Yes, my lord.
You know, it's funny how faith works. Your father was Attila's aide, and now that we have defeated Attila, you are my aide. Don't worry about it. It's all politics. I'm one of them too. The barbarians. I was born of the Scythian tribe.
The Scythians? The same Scythians that were fighting alongside Attila?
Yeah, that's right. Ones we've defeated. Just as Visigoths were fighting alongside us. Yes, my friend, that's the Roman way. It is us Romans against them, the enemy. Simple as that. No more, no less. Look at him, Livius. Cheering at us. Like they'll live forever. Defeated Attila, but there's millions of them just like him, and waiting at the gates of Rome, waiting to crush us. Ostrogoths, Visigoths, Longobards, Longobards, Fangs, Salons, Vandals. Everybody. Yeah. I just can't help being weary of all this new German union with Rome.
Well, my lord, with all due respect, we just defeated the greatest enemy Rome has ever known. You should at least be thankful for that.
Yes, I know, Livius. I can't help being skeptical. You know? Now that we've defeated Attila and Attila's out of the picture, it's only a matter of time that the Germans unite against us. Yes, my friend, that's the truth of it. Yeah. We've let the Visigoths settle in Italy under the condition that they fight for Rome. Hell, we've even let the Saxons settle. The same Saxons that have been sacking Britannia. And even the better paradox is that the Britons are asking me to help them in the campaign against the Saxons, and now Saxons are fighting with us. Oh, the politics. It has been a long German dream for 400 years to sack Rome. Why would they succumb to us now? No, Livius. Germans know we're weak. They know our empire is hanging on threads. It's only a matter of time. It's only a matter of time. All of them. Just waiting for the right time to crush us. Sharks waiting for the leftovers. civilization that's crumbling. Look at Amybius, hailing us like we're gods. But only 6 months ago, the Senate wouldn't even approve of this campaign. Yeah, look at him now.
Well, what can one say? Victory is glorious.
Yeah, I can say one thing. Thank God I'm not a politician. The only reason I'm still alive, because I'm neither warm nor cold, so both God and devil spit me out. And the truth is, Thibius, I'm tired. I'm tired of this. I'm tired of this whole thing. I'm tired of war, of politics, of it all. Libius.
Yes, my lord.
I don't know how long I still have. And my son is still very young. You understand?
Yes, my lord.
Now I trust you. You're a good man. Not many I can say this about. You're a good man. Always remember that.
Thank you, my lord. Thank you.
Okay, enough about politics. There's plenty of food, wine, and women to go around for everybody. We can always die tomorrow. Fibium!
Yes, my lord.
The men haven't had a company of a woman in months. The streets of Rome are filled with beautiful women. I do not wish to hear of any inadequate behavior by my centurions. Is that understood?
Yes, my lord.
Good. Okay, Libius, let's go. You know, I might be old, but I still got it where it counts.
Yes, my lord.
Flavius Aetius. Congratulations are in order.
Senator Magnus, Senator Avitus. May we congratulate you on your great victory, General Aetius.
Thank you, and may we congratulate you, Senator Avitus.
It seems that your idea to unite the Visigoths and the Romans in Gaul actually worked in our favor after all.
Senator Magnus, I understand when I was gone, freeing the Empire from the Huns, there have been some new interesting developments in the Eastern Empire. A certain council in Bethany, a continuation of Mycenae.
Yes, our Greek patrician, Consul Anatolius, has been participating in some various preparations for a new council at Chalcedon.
If we may continue this conversation another time. Senator Avitus, Senator Magnus, Rome is calling me. Excuse me.
General?
politicians. A general politician. Now we wait.
Aren't you on duty, soldier? Aren't you on duty?
Yes, my lord. My apologies, my lord.
Felicia.
Flavius.
Where are you from, soldier?
Dalmatia, my lord.
Dalmatia. Carry on.
Yes, my lord.
Thank you. Oh, Dario.
Flavius.
Fire of Namibia.
The Laron of Scythia.
How are you, my friend?
Huh? I'm good, my lord.
I haven't seen you since the battle.
I'm alive. I'm alive. Just like you.
Good. What about your brother? How is Septimo?
He's good.
He's alive.
He's alive.
Good. Where is he?
After Chaland, they sent him back to the Britannia Legions. As he knows the terrain there well.
What a lion, huh? Well, my friend, good. I'm glad both of you are well. That's good. Well, as you can see, what's going on around here. Yes, I can tell you this, my friend. Take your pick. Tribune. I guess that's that for adequate behavior of my centurions, huh? Don't worry about it, it's okay. Ethius.
Yes, my lord.
Help me out with this.
Yes, my lord.
Thank you. It is Heathus, right?
Yes, my lord.
Well, tell me, Heathus, how are the Centurions?
The Centurions?
Yeah.
Oh, the Centurions, sir.
Yeah.
Every man is in his place. Everyone is fine. Everyone is in their place.
No. How are the Centurions? How are the men? How's everything?
Everyone is good, my lord. Everything is good.
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 How are you?
Me, my lord?
Yeah, how are you?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm good. I'm good. Thank you, my lord. Thank you. The men are good, my lord. Everything is good.
Good, good. Good. You know, with this, I don't get to speak to the Centurions that much anymore, you know? I don't talk to the men anymore. I should, you know. I need to talk to the men more often, you know? It was good talking to you. We should talk some more.
Of course, I agree, my lord.
We should do it more often.
I agree, my lord.
At ease.
Attila. De morso, huh? I guess we're not immortal, are we? Son, come over here. Aetius. Son.
Love is Aetius. No. Drink with me, come on. Tell me about your victories. What happened? Whoa! Tell me something.
Tribune.
Yes, my lord.
What's your name, Tribune?
Anthony, my lord.
Anthony. Anthony. How old are you?
19 or 18, my lord.
You're not sure?
I was an orphan, my lord.
Anthony, take her.
Take me, Anthony.
You heard me. It's okay. I know.
My lord?
I know. Take her. You deserve it. After what we've been through, you deserve it more than anybody.
Take me, Anthony. Let's go.
Hi. My lord.
Oh, that's
good. No problem. Tell her about the hunts and how beautifully they smell.
Have you ever seen a hunt from up close?
No, I
haven't. The smell will knock you out.
Son, come over here. Aetius. Come over here. Aetius.
Son.
You want this sword, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
That's not funny, actually.
Come here.
No, not yet.
Nothing glorious about killing.
I've killed many men, son. Many men. I've lost even more.
Brave men, young men. Some haven't even had a woman yet. They've tasted steel. There's nothing glorious about it, son. Nothing at all.
Yeah, but then again, what do you know about this? You're just a baby. I'm telling you all this stuff, what do you know?
I'm a big boy.
Are you a big boy?
Mm-hmm.
That's it. You're a like your father, right? Look at me. Look around you. Okay. One way or the other, it's gonna be okay. Understand? Now, look around you, son. Look around. This is Rome. This is what your father fought for. I want you to know this. It existed for over 1,000 years because of people like your father, the legionaries.
People like me and you.
There's nothing glorious about it, son. Don't believe what they tell you about ideologies. Roman Caesars have come and gone, senators, politicians. But the Roman legions, that's the backbone that makes it last for so long. Remember that, son. It's based on blood and blades, and putting fear in those we conquer. I've lost many men. I've killed many men. Many men, son. This is Rome. This is the mighty Rome that your father fought for. Okay? Blades and blood, my son. Just for the power. Men's hunger for power, my son. There's nothing glorious about it. Do you understand me? Okay. We made it possible for it to be the way it is.
Fire in our heart.
The fire in our heart that burns forever. Do you understand? That's what makes us men. Okay? Son, I want you to remember something. I know you're too young to understand, but one day you'll understand. One day. One day when I'm no longer around, and you're defending Rome, and you're on the battlefield, waiting for the enemy to charge, you're gonna feel something in your stomach. That's fear, son, fear. Never give in to fear. Never be afraid, son. You understand? Remember the fire. Right here, in the heart. Right here. The fire that burns forever. Without heart, we're nothing. Never be afraid. In life or death, it's always gonna be okay. Remember.
Can I
have every great general I can? That I promise you, son. One day you'll be the greatest general Rome has ever seen.
I want to be the best general. I want to be the fucking father.
People of Rome, let me know in the four corners of the empire that this is my son. My son. Aetius, Patius, Majorian. The future commander of all the Roman armies. My son.
has been known and speculated for some time now about these potential developments in Rome. The situation is delicate, my friends, I know. But we must not jump to any quick conclusion. One thing is certain. The Senate cannot submit to any mindless speculations. We must negotiate a solution as the Senate always has. Therefore, the Senate cannot succumb to any simplistic solutions. My Caesar.
My Caesar. Honorable Senators of Rome.
General Aetius.
Yes, my Caesar.
What news do you bring us?
Odoacer and his army of Ostrogoths have sacked the city of Ravenna, and they're on their way here. I'm afraid the omens are bad, my Caesar.
Omens? And what omens would that be, General Aetius? Honorable Romans, citizens, senators of Rome, do you hear what our honorable Patrius Majorian would tell us? We're doomed!
As commander of all the Roman armies, I don't feel adequately appropriate reporting to you, honorable senator.
Oh, but this is the Roman Senate, the will of the people of Rome.
My Caesar, we should start to evacuate the city.
Rome has existed for over 1,000 years, young Aetius. For all those centuries, the Senate of Rome has been the heart of Rome. Rome cannot fall.
Evacuate? You think you can predict the omens of Rome? Change the will of Rome? You're just the general. We are the Senate, Senatus, patres et conscripti, the center, the heart, the fathers of Rome. You would oppose the will of the Roman Senate, the heart of Rome?
Fathers of Rome. Heart? You? Look around you. Can't you see what's happening? You want to talk about the heart? You want to talk about the heart of Rome? You must first have a heart.
We have our Caesar.
Rome has existed for over 1,000 years. It is the center of the world. Rome will not fall.
And as long as we have our Caesar, we have our heart.
Heart. Heart. Like my father. Flavius Aetius. Rome will fall. It's just a matter of time.
Fall! How dare you!
Yes! Fall! Or do you want me to lie? Like you. And tell you what. How the gates of Rome are safe. How there is no danger. No barbarians waiting to come in and crush us. My father spoke of people like you. Selling Rome for personal gain. Piece by piece, until there is nothing left to sell.
But
my father was the better man. He was beyond that bickering and greed that corrupts man. That's why he had to go. That's why he had to be killed. That's why he had to go. Isn't it? Isn't it? How could you ever row with a man like Flavius Aetius in your way? It's unnatural to your kind. All that Rome is worth to you is the value of denarii you've been selling it for all these years. I've just come from the gates of Rome. I've seen the barbarians. I've smelled them. Thousands of them, ready to come in and attack at any time. Wake up! Our Rome is falling!
Aetius.
Yes, my Caesar.
Dear Aetius. Patrius Majorian, you, of all the warriors of Rome, the most Roman of them all. I remember you when I was a little boy, and out of all the defenders of Rome, I always looked up to you the most. The true defender of Rome.
My Caesar, we can still get you to safety. We must leave now. Our carriage is outside ready to take you as we speak. But we must leave. There's no more time. The south of Rome is still defended by the legions. We can take you as far as Napolis tonight. From where the galleys will take you to the island of Capri. There you would be safe, for the moment. And then, via Sicily, we can transport you all the way to Constantinople, in the east.
Aetius.
Yes, my Caesar.
My dear Aetius. I can't leave. I belong here. These are my people. Oh, my dear General Aetius. If it is the will of God that Rome shall fall, then my place is with her. Remembered as Romulus Augustulus, who stood with Rome until the end.
Yes, my Caesar.
So is my will, and the will of the people. Go on now, my friend. Defend our Rome. Give it your best. Strength and honor.
Strength and honor.
My skin on. Oh.